Today I'm going to show you a quick tip tutorial in V-Ray on how to quickly add decals and logos onto your mesh. I have a simple mesh here and I'm going to add a unwrap UVW. I'm going to open the UV editor and at the moment I'm going to select all the elements and move them away. Now I'm going to select where my logo is going to come or will be placed, something like this, for example. Next, I'm going to click on the quick peel and back. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to move this channel on channel number 2 because I want to put my logos on a separate channel so that it doesn't interfere with the rest. So this is my logo. Okay, I'm going to put this on the side. Next, I'm going to start my rendering. And let me just show you my setup. Oh, sorry. As you can see at the moment, we don't have any logos on there. So I'm using a blend material. This is your base shader. It can be anything you want. A metallic, paint, doesn't matter. This is just an example. The top layer is your logo layer. So you can give it any color that you want. Doesn't matter. The third step is to have an alpha of your logo. So, once you have chosen your alpha as your logo, what is very important is that you match the channel from the UV. If you put this on 1, your logo will not display. If you put this on 2, Max knows where to place this this logo onto the coordinates. It's very important, of course. I'm using a composite, but I will show you why. So it's very easy. You just connect the alpha to the blend amount and you should see your logo here. The color of the amount, if you put it on white, it will not work. So put it on black. Now with your UVW window, where is it? You can still manipulate this. If I move it, you will see that the logo will move. So you can still kind of scale it if you want to make it bigger. You can rotate it. You can do whatever you want. So now that you know that, you can come a little bit closer. You have total control over your logo. You can change the color to any color that you want. You also have control over your reflectivity. You can remove it, you can edit the amount, doesn't matter. You can increase or decrease the Fresnel, it will all work. So I'm also using a bump in the logo from the alpha. You can also use a displacement if you want. This composite layer, you can use that to break up the logo. So you can bring a grunge texture, but I'm going to use maybe a smoke, I don't know. And put that into the mask layer. And you see you can break up the logo. You can even animate this threshold. Whatever you want. Again, you can input this then as a bump. So this is how I do it.